to the red carpet celebrity lanes, Milwaukee, Wisconsin, for this $125,000 Classic. We're happy to have you with us on this Saturday. Hello, everybody. Jay Randolph along with Hall of Famer Earl Anthony. This is the 24th consecutive year that the PBA Tour has come to Milwaukee, and they love their bowling here.
They do. The cities like Milwaukee, Chicago, St. Louis, they are the bowling cities, you might say, the capitals of bowling in this country, Jay. They are what makes bowling a great sport.
Earl, the scores have not been high this week. We had no 300 games, and it's going to be very interesting in the stepladder finals.
It is. It's a very experienced field. The top five are very experienced players, and that's what you had to be on what the players call a professional lane condition, a difficult condition. You have to make great adjustments moving pair to pair, and the carry is difficult. It's a lot of 10 pins, a lot of 4 pins.
All right, let's get right to the action. Match one of this event coming up right now, Amleto Monacelli against David Ozio. Monacelli in the blue shirt will start things off, qualifying fifth with a 211.73 tournament average. 28 years old, 5'8", 150 pounds, and he generates a lot of power for a little man. And he leaves the 10 pin.
This is the kind of lane condition, Jay, as we've talked about a little bit in the opening, that is difficult moving pair to pair. And when you get lined up on one specific pair like 63 and 64, you can shoot some good scores. The problem is carrying the 10 pin or the 4 pin. You cannot circle the ball a lot. You can't get it very wide and expect it to hook back. If it does, it will leave the 10 pin. If it doesn't quite get back, it's a 2-8-10 or something as difficult like a washout. So the players have to keep the ball in line and still roll it with a very heavy roll, such as this man here, David Ozio, is capable of doing, and to make the ball hit to carry the corners.
Ozio leaving a 10 pin on lane 64 as he begins play, 35 years old out of Vidor, Texas, 12 years out here on tour. After five rounds, he was sixth, and he made it into the top five yesterday.
A real premium on spare shooting here. If you leave corners, you've got to make them because strikes are hard to get. Here's a good look at David Ozio's form. As you notice, he switched bowling balls. He went to a very smooth shell plastic ball, so the ball would skid cross lane for the 10 pin.
Now, Ozio, an avid bass fisherman, a fellow who practices diligently on tour.
Practices fishing or bowling?
Both.
Both.
Oh. All right. Amleto missed the first three events on the fall tour because of a hip injury. He did it riding a bicycle. And a strike.
Now, there's some power for you, Jay. This is what players would like to do, what they call shred the rack. You watch that ball go into the pin area between the one and the three pin and just destroy the pins. That's the power that this young guy, even though he's only 5'8", maybe 150 pounds, soaking wet, maybe even with his bowling ball, Jay,
right,
he can get that bowling ball to turn over and destroy those pins.
Down goes the 10, and Amleto has a double.
This is a unique style, one of few. Now watch what he does with his shoulders. They'll open up, and then he'll square up at the bottom. And the reason he opens his shoulder is so he can get more speed, a higher backswing, more speed, because he's such a little guy, he has to generate speed somehow, and that's how he gets it. And then the classic style of Dave Ozio, very square to the foul line, that straight up follow through. The result's the same.
There's Ozio's wife. And a couple of their wives here today. Lisa Ozio.
A little tug on the ear for luck there, Jay.
Teresa Monacelli.
Amleto's wife also looking on.
Well, both of these fellas looking very sharp in the early going.
Ozio is up by 10.
This is the PBA Fall Tour, and today it's being brought to you by Budweiser, Beechwood Aged for that clean, crisp taste. This Bud's for you. By your Toyota dealers and their quality line of cars and trucks. Toyota, I love what you do for me. By First Brands Corporation, makers of Crestone Advanced Formula Antifreeze. And by Sinex Ultra Fine Mist, the nasal spray that goes up and stays up.
For most of us, the only thing that's more fun than staying home to watch the game is going out to watch the game. So come on down, catch the game this week with Bud and Bud Light, and enjoy all the action on and off the field.
You got it now.
Uh-oh. I bet I'll get you there.
I love what you do for me.
At a pro shop near you, Brunswick is delivering a 100% urethane monster.
What?
We're delivering the power of a rhino. The hardest charging ball in America. Five distinct formulations. Brunswick's Rhino reigns.
Janitor to the pro shop, please.
Amleto Monacelli getting set in the sixth frame on lane 64. He's down 22 pins. Needs the strike and gets it. Ozio has come up with five strikes in a row now. Monacelli left the 6-10 in the fifth, converted. There's his wife, Teresa. And now the strike in the sixth. High, and the 10-pin is standing. The loser here, who finishes fifth, will pick up $4,500. Amleto left the 10-pin in the first, left the 6-10 in the fifth, now has that 10-pin here in the seventh.
The lane, the lane condition has favored the player, Jay, that can get the ball well down the lane before it grips the lane, and that's the kind of player that Monacelli has been all week, and of course David Ozio.
We'll be right back with more action from the Milwaukee Classic after this timeout.
Why is it, Lou, you come in here every morning and order a large orange juice?
I like orange juice.
Oh, really?
It's got potassium, vitamin C, lots of vitamin C.
Orange juice. It's got the vitamins, minerals, and taste that make you feel so good.
Come on, Lou. Isn't there another reason?
Well, I kind of like the company.
100% pure, Florida-quality orange juice. It makes you feel so good.
Here, have another glass, Lou.
Thanks.
It's 32 degrees. It's getting late. And Jan Trumpeter is learning all about her antifreeze.
Closed.
Your look. Guarantee it with Advanced Formula Prestone. It's only at Sears. This 3-lux camcorder that shoots beautifully even in low light.
Hold it. Hold.
For just $21 a month. Comes with free wide angle and telephoto lenses. And color enhancement light too. At Sears and Sears Grand Central now.
To make wrenching fast and easy, you can either do this or get this. The Skill Wrench Cordless Power Wrench. It's revolutionary.
The average leaders keep Weber up on top. Dave Ferraro, he'll be the defending champion next week at Taylor, Michigan. Monacelli, who you're watching right now, followed by Ballard and Mike Albee. Albee did not cash here in Milwaukee this week, and he still is at the $293,000 mark, with a chance to go over $300,000 next week. Now Ozio, with the lead in this match, getting set in the seventh frame. Fine opening match.
He is, and what a great shot that was of how to roll the ball properly and get the right rotation to carry the 10-pin. Dave Ozio at the foul line, so solid. His fundamentals are so good. He's just making great shots, Jay. It's just hard to find fault with a player that is making such good, solid shots as he is right now.
He's been dead solid perfect since the first frame when he left the 10-pin. Here's a 7 standing.
That's the worst shot he's made in the match through 8 frames, Jay, and still had a chance to get the strike. Watch the pin action. Watch the rotation as the ball grips the lane, turns sideways, just gets enough of the head pin to mix him up, but not quite get the 7 pin. He'll switch balls and go straight at the corner.
Monacelli in a hole right now. He's down 31.
Still has a chance. Again, here, these are the frames, the foundation frames, 8th, 9th, and 10th, coming up for Monacelli, a possible 248 score if he strikes out. Ozio going at a 249 pace. That's trouble.
Never got up.
Never had a chance. He got it out there in what the players call the out-of-bounds area. When you get it outside the track area, which is basically between the second and third arrow, it doesn't get any friction. The ball won't grip the lane. It'll skid. It gets too far down the lane before it starts to grip the lane. It never gets back to the head pin.
1, 2, 8, 10.
He'll go straight at it.
And he is open. Really puts Ozio in the driver's seat.
It does. Basically, this match now is over, and Monacelli, a very disappointed young man, but he's had a great year, Jay. Still has a chance to get to that $200,000 mark with maybe a win next week.
And a 10-pin on lane 63.
Monacelli is a good example of a lot of the talent, the very young, talented, good foreign players that have come to join the PBA players and bowl on the tour. As you see there, he's in third place on the money standings this year. People like Mats Carlson, others have demonstrated that bowling is truly an international sport, Dave.
Carlson will be your guest a little later on in Earl's Corner, your feature, and you'll talk a little bit about the international bowling scene. Ozio needs 8 pins on his first ball to shut the door right here. And that's the end of the problem.
That is the end of the problem, but he's glad that happened now rather than in his next match. Here's a look at the power, and look at the good follow-through, the good, solid balance at the foul line. Now watch how hard this ball hits. Doesn't deflect, and that's why he leaves the solid 8. It takes the 5 straight back off the 8. And I've said before in the past, if you're going to throw a lot of strikes, the ball has to deflect a little bit.
Ozio, the winner of this first match. I mentioned that he bowled pretty well here in Wisconsin. He was 4th at the LaMode Classic in Green Bay earlier.
Didn't expect this kind of scoring, Jay. I'm surprised. They haven't had good scores throughout the week. But again, when they line up on one pair, the scores have been much better when they got a chance to stay on one pair. And watch how hard this ball hits. They haven't been able to make the ball hit this well all week. And still get over into 5 over to get the 7 out.
Ozio top-seeded at the Kessler Classic out in California, and he lost the title to Price, 202 to 191. But he marches to victory in fine fashion here in this first match over Monacelli. And going up against Big Mark Baker, who's been down to the right side, loosening up. For David Ozio, 248 here in this opening match. She likes it. And Amleto Monacelli just finishing things up as he's left a 2-4-10 here in the 10th frame.
Well, we'll see if Monacelli wants to show off a little bit, Jay. It's a tough spare, but he's very capable of making it. And I think he'll give it a shot. He's not just going to finish out. He's got a lot of pride. He's going to go for it.
Almost kicked back. A score of 189 for Amleto Monacelli. David Ozio has won match one of this Milwaukee Classic. More action coming up in a moment.
Users of ordinary nasal sprays will do almost anything to keep the spray up in their nose where it can work.
Morning, Morgan.
Which is why so many people now use Sinex Ultra Fine Mist. It's twice as fine as ordinary sprays, so its medicine goes up and stays up to give you the best relief possible. You don't have to stand on your head to get relief. Just get Sinex Ultra Fine Mist. Promise that their balls will do all kinds of tricks to improve your score. But at AMF, we know nothing helps like power. That's why our new Cobra has a computer-designed strike coil weight block and 71% more urethane. So get a Cobra for striking power you can rely on, instead of tricks you can't.
Amleto Monacelli finishing fifth as David Ozio is the winner, 248 to 189 in match one of the Milwaukee Classic. I want to remind you of the bowling shootout coming to NBC Sports World in December. Mark Roth, Marshall Holman, Lisa Wagner, they'll be joined by a non-professional, a survivor of a nationwide competition to challenge for $100,000 in prize money. That's on NBC Sports World, December 9th. And of course, the playoff race is heating up. Hope you'll join NBC Sports for football beginning at 12:30 Eastern time tomorrow. NFL Live will set it up for you. Most of you see the Bengals, and they'll travel to Buffalo to face the Bills. Others will watch the Patriots battle Bo Jackson and the Raiders. You want to check your local listings for the game to be seen in your area. NFL football tomorrow. Mark Baker on the left, David Ozio on the right. Match two of this $125,000 Milwaukee Classic. Ozio is surprised, Earl Anthony and others, with his fine bowling here. His score of 248. Very, very excellent. And he starts off leaving a four pin down there.
He's getting such a heavy roll on the ball. David has always been a very accurate player, and he's rolled the ball well, but he's really getting a heavy roll, more so than I've ever seen him in the past, and his ball's hitting very hard.
Mark Baker, the newlywed, married 3 weeks, married the former Jeannie DeSalvo on November the 4th back in Southern California. It was quite an affair, and he's got a split right off the bat. 6-7-10.
We're going to take another look at that, Jay, and now watch how early the ball gets on the lane. See how quickly the ball hit the lane? And what that does, creates a lot of friction early. It makes the ball grip the lane too soon, and it goes through the middle hit pin. And that's an opening shot. It shows a little bit of bad nerves on Mark's part. But he's watch this. He's going to go for it. He could get very close. The skids where he wants. Gave it a good try.
Baker's best man was PBA champion Dave Husted. As you get a good look at the nine-year veteran of the tour, one of his groomsmen, the current Philadelphia Phillies and former Met outfielder Lenny Dykstra, this fellow really does love sports of all kinds.
He was a great basketball player. I think All-American in high school.
And he comes back with a strike.
Here he gets the ball well down the lane, Jay. This is a complete opposite of the shot earlier. He followed through with this one straight out and up. It's something Dave Ozio does as well as you can. His follow through is straight up over his target. Watch how the arm goes straight out and up over the target. That's what creates accuracy in that heavy roll. If the player follows through to the left or the right, Jay, it shows a lack of confidence. He's not really making a good shot. Watch this follow through straight up. Dave's bowling with a lot of confidence right now.
And picks up the 2-4 and has a 9-pin lead.
You know,
qualified for only one telecast last year, Earl, but he made the most of it, winning his fourth career title down in Edmond, Oklahoma. Rolled three strikes in the 10th frame to knock off top-seeded Del Warren in that one.
He's a great pressure player. He can definitely handle the pressure, and it comes from having great fundamentals, and that's what Dave has. He gets to the foul line so solid, that follow-through straight up and out and over his target. It's very hard to make a mistake when you have those kind of fundamentals.
Baker on 64. And a two-pin. Baker had the most games over 200 here this week, 30. His PBA earnings of over $546,000. Second appearance in the championship round this year. Finished fifth earlier at the Society Bank PBA National Championship in Toledo. Disgusted at this point in the proceedings.
Well, here's a guy that uses a lot of strength. Now, he's 6'4", 220. Watch how he whips the ball through. It feels to him like a grapefruit, where it feels like a cannonball to you and I, Jay. But this fella is so strong that, and he uses that strength to overpower the lane condition many times. This particular type of lane condition, that's what you had to do on certain pairs, and he's been capable of doing that. He led the tournament by as much as 300 pins at various times this week.
Baker was the leader after the first round, leader after the third, fourth, and fifth round. Brian Voss vaulted into the top position last night here. Baker struggling a little bit in the early going, is down 10. More action from Milwaukee right after we take timeout for these messages.
Some steaks and get the queen a Bud Light.
Oh. For clean, fresh taste, one light outshines them all. Bud Light.
Henry, they're pop tops.
Because everything else, is just a light.
If you have a house as messy as this, and a son as helpful as this, get a shop vac. Look at the power this baby's got. A shop vac wet dry picks up everything from nails and wood chips to broken glass to gallons of water.
Thanks for the car, Dad.
Yep, there's no telling when you'll need the power of a shop vac.
Now, shop vac introduces Spot Check for tough carpet stains. Spot Check turns any shop vac into a powerful carpet cleaner.
Hey, come here. Closer. Don't see any dandruff, do you?
I used to have it. Boy, did I ever. So I tried Head & Shoulders. Then I tried my wife, Selsun Blue. She was right. Blue is better.
Blue is better. Selsun Blue. Tests show Selsun Blue relieves dandruff flaking better than Head & Shoulders. And doctors recommend it number one. More than Head & Shoulders, Denorex, and Tegrin combined.
For me, there's no doubt about it. Blue is better.
Selsun Blue. Normal, extra medicated, and extra conditioning formulas.
A great Thanksgiving tradition. The Skins game returns to NBC, where one putt could be worth $450,000. Jack Nicklaus, Curtis Strange, Ray Floyd, and Lee Trevino play The Skins game this weekend on NBC.
Here's the prize money this week as we're on hand at the red carpet celebrity lanes in Milwaukee. $18,000 first prize. Mark Baker in the fifth. And it came up a little short. Ozio left the 3-6-9-10 in the fourth and was open. And now Baker with the 2-4-5 here in the fifth. Lanes are changing, Earl, as you predicted.
They'll change, especially when they'll have to put the lane condition here, Jay. The surface itself is rough, the first 15 feet, the head area.
Baker.
And he missed it, right.
Yeah, opportunity there to really get back into the thick of it, and here it is.
And the ball will slide by. He tried to go hard and straight at it, and it never gripped when it got down to the other end. What happens with the first 15 feet of the lane being so rough? The people that put the oil on the lanes have to put more than they normally would to keep the ball from gripping too much. And then when the ball picks it up and carries it down, it changes how the ball reacts on the lane surface. So you get caught in kind of a catch-22 situation where if you put enough oil to make them playable in the first part of the lane, the other end of the lane gets too tough. If you don't put enough in the front, then you can't get it down the lane. So it's kind of a tough situation for the lane man. And it gets tougher for the players through the transition period. But these are very experienced players, all five of them. They will adjust as the lanes change. It'll take them a few frames, that's all.
Baker, with only one strike through the first six frames, came up a little light there in the sixth, left the 4-7, converted. And now Ozio in the sixth with a 12-pin lead. Ozio on the TV pair, 195 average this week. His high game was 259. He defeated Monacelli 248 to 189 in match one. And a strike for David Ozio.
Now, David has made the adjustment already, and he's, as I mentioned before, is bowling with a lot of confidence. Watch the follow through straight out and up over the target. Very loose, relaxed follow through, and that's why he's making such good shots. He's made the adjustment. He's confident with his game. Mark Baker, on the other hand, coming over, he's only bowled five or six frames. He really hasn't found the lanes yet.
And down goes the 10. Three in a row for David Ozio. Ozio has a 32-pin lead, and we'll be back with more right after this from your local station.
Click it, press it, click it, tune it in, turn it on. This is what you watch it on. Any way you work it, integrate your circuit of the city. Circuit City.
Come to the place you welcome. Technology with a heart. Welcome to Circuit City, where service is state of the art.
At Circuit City, we get higher customer satisfaction ratings than any other specialty home electronics and appliance chain.
Welcome to Circuit City, where service is state of the art.
The breathtaking Lexus has arrived in the Delaware Valley. A remarkable engineering achievement, Lexus has thought of everything, says Road and Track. Breathtaking, faultless, says Motor Trend. Lease the ES250 for as low as $277 a month. Test drive a Lexus at Lexus of Cherry Hill, Thompson Lexus, Wilkie Lexus. One of the best cars in the world, says Fortune Magazine. It's likely they'll go fast.
Honesty and quality. That's how we get the job done right the first time at Cottman Transmission. With honesty, you'll know that we fix only what needs fixing. Our technicians have the best training for your car or truck. Cottman backs up their commitment to quality with a nationwide guarantee. Cottman is determined to give you the best service possible. So when you look for honesty and quality, look to Cottman. See your Cottman transmission specialist in Broomall, Mapleshade, and Lansdale.
Next week, Evenings in Vegas.
They love him here in Milwaukee, and for that matter, just about everywhere. Al McGuire's preseason basketball schedule is coming up next. The special will bring you up to date on who he thinks are going to really be the contenders this season. The coach, Al McGuire, next. And that, of course, will be followed by the Skins game. Floyd, Strange, Nicholas, and Trevino, $450,000. The match, the Skins game from the desert. And here in Milwaukee, Mark Baker has got his hands full. There's his high game this week, 248. Well, he continues to have trouble at the six pin. As Earl mentioned, Baker's been in the thick of it all week. He was never worse than third.
Mark had a lot of trouble in Friday's two eight-game rounds of match play. He bowled great through Thursday. The lanes changed a little bit on Friday, as they will, from day to day, and he just couldn't make the adjustment, and it's carried into today's round. As I mentioned, he had a 300-pin lead at one point Friday morning, and I talked to him last night, and he said, I just feel lucky to hang on and make the telecast.
I mentioned that Mike Albee, still shooting for $300,000, did not cash here this week. He finished 101 in the field.
Well, he beat about 59 guys then, I guess.
Yeah. Well, Baker has really struggled here. He leaves a 1-2-8. Here's the leading money winners list. And Monacelli today picking up $4,500. Mike Albee at 293, 215. And he'll see what he can do next week in Taylor, Michigan, as Baker is open again.
David Ozio, no question, is in the driver's seat. And we're going to get a good look at what happens here when you set the ball early and it doesn't quite grip the lane the way he wants it to. And Mark Baker is thinking, well, it was a good week, but it's all over. Maybe next week.
Well, and a little frustration for Ozio. After three in a row, he leaves a 2-4-5-8 here in the eighth frame.
The ups and downs emotionally that these players go through from day to day or from game to game, Jay, is unbelievable. The physical strain isn't that much, but the emotional stress, it can just eat you alive. As you saw the look on Mark Baker's face, he's sitting there with his head, he's shaking his head a little bit, and he's thinking back to on Thursday, I had a 300-pin lead on Friday morning. I was bowling so good. What happened? He's looking at making $18,000 and picking up another championship. Now all of a sudden he's going to have trouble shooting 150 in the championship round.
A 4-pin for Ozio. Baker right now would have a possible 179 if he went all the way. Ozio with a spare in the ninth and a lead of 42.
And he's pretty well got this match in hand, Jay. Mark Baker kind of wondering what's going on out there. He's really lost. His TV record hasn't been the best over the years. He's struggled. He's either shot the real big game or gotten in trouble as he is right now.
Ozio is the winner. There he is. And he took Monacelli in match one and now wins over Baker here in match two and will go up against the veteran Bob Handley in our third match.
You know who it was good to see back this week, Jay, and it's been a long time for both players? Mike Jasmine. What a great shot.
All right. Baker says, all right, but what the heck?
Yeah,
huh?
We're going to get another look at this now. Watch this. This is a great shot. And He's so frustrated right now. Anything makes you feel good. And that's, he's just going for this because it just makes him feel good to pick up a tough spare, the 4-9. Big smile on his face. But it's great to see two of our youngest stars, Ricky Steelsmith and Mike Zasna, back bowling this week after long, debilitating injuries. Both players had terrible injuries, rotator cuff injuries, forearm injuries. And now they're back, and they're bowling again. And Mike cashed this week. Mike Zasna got a check by one pin, but he did get back in the money. Ricky Steelsmith bowled last week and this week, and he hasn't cashed yet. But he's a former Rookie of the Year, and it's nice to see them both back. And Mike wanted to say hi to his sister, Jeanette, in California. And hope everything's going well for her.
A lot of talent out here these days.
Oh, boy.
Well, Baker at least finishing it off in pretty good form here. They're picking up that fine spare in the ninth and two strikes here in the tenth.
This is a little bit more the kind of scores I expected, Jay, the 170, 180, 190, 2-0 type, which has been kind of predominant throughout the week.
He won the high average award back in 85. Baker ends up with a score of 166.
And that shows you just how good David Ozio is playing today, to shoot 248 the first game and come back right now with a chance for another 200 game, because they have been premium. 200 games are tough to get this week.
2-4-5 leave. And Ozio converts. Ozio was in 20th position after round two, and he moved into third. He dropped out of the top five after five and got back in the top five last evening. And David Ozio, with a score of 196, is the winner over Mark Baker. Coming up, match three, it will be Ozio going up against Bob Handley. That's right after this.
Now, at a pro shop near you, Brunswick is delivering a 100% urethane monster.
What?
We're delivering the power of a rhino. The hardest charging ball in America. Five distinct formulations. Brunswick's Rhino reigns.
Janitor to the pro shop, please.
They say drink plenty of fluids. Swallowing's total pain.
Introducing new advanced formula chloraseptic with the power of phenol. It penetrates nerve endings to work on contact, so it gives the fastest relief. And nothing lasts longer. New advanced formula chloraseptic works fastest, and nothing lasts longer. Now the fast, long-lasting relief of advanced formula chloraseptic comes in new cool mint spray. Also, try new cool mint lozenges.
Thank you. And so, Mayor, these swiftly flowing currents create energy, which in turn creates power, which in turn brings electric light to every house in the valley.
That's very impressive, Calvin.
Thank you, sir.
But the contract calls for bringing Bud Light to the valley.
No wonder we're over budget.
Bud Light won't fill you up and never lets you down.
Which in turn keeps the Bud Light controlled.
Because everything else is just a light.
NBC Sports serves your need to know all week long. Dial 1-900-454-3500 for NBC Scores Plus. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, anywhere in the USA.
Most anyone that bowls anywhere in the world is very aware of the Professional Bowlers Association, where the best bowlers in the world do compete. But also, there's a Japanese tour where some of the other Asians compete with the Japanese, and they can make a pretty good living at it over there. What there isn't is a European tour. And there's a lot of reasons why. And with me today to try to explain some of those reasons is one of the great players from Europe, is Mats Carlson, four-time PBA champion. Mats, tell us a little bit about the European players and why they don't want to compete, maybe professionally.
It's a couple of reasons why they don't want to compete professionally. One is that they cannot bowl for the national team if they compete, if they become a PBA member. And it's another thing that they have a lot of money in a lot of amateur tournaments overseas where they can make pretty good money too.
Uh-huh. And you mentioned that if they make more than 50% of their money, say, throwing a bowling ball, they lose that amateur status, and they can't compete for the national team, they can't compete in any of the amateur tournaments, and they're completely locked out as far as being an amateur bowler is concerned.
That's right. And I also think that a lot of those guys overseas, or I know all the guys overseas, they were more than happy to compete on the PBA Tour, because I think a lot of the bowlers overseas are they can compete out here. I mean, they're good enough where they can make some money out here too.
You think they can win? You think they'd be better than the guys that are here, Matt? Tell us the truth now.
The best guys in the world is always here. I mean, it's here. There's no doubt about that. It's a lot of guys' gold to be a professional bowler, because here is the best bowlers in the world, and here is what everybody wants to bowl.
All right. Thank you, Matt. The best bowlers in the world are still here, but the Europeans are proving that they're very capable of competing with us.
David Ozio comes up a winner in match two, 196 to 166. Over Baker. And Ozio will be going up against Handley tomorrow. Remember, the playoff action beginning to heat up. Cincinnati Bengals and the Buffalo Bills. Bo Jackson will be in action for the Raiders as they go against the Patriots. NFL Live at 12:30 tomorrow. Check your local listings for the NFL action in your area. There's Handley on the left. Ozio on the right. And they're getting set for this third match. Baker pulls down $5,500 for finishing fourth. The loser of this match will win $7,000. And Ozio starts on lane 63 with a strike.
Here you get an idea of how the scores were. His high game of the week for 42 games was 259. He started today's match play on television with a 248 game. That's a tremendous score. To give you an idea what the scoring was like, 53rd place, last in the money this week, took a 203 average. To make the top 24, the match play, a 208 average. So the scores weren't very high, Jay.
And Handley's got a problem right off the bat, the 4-6-7. Handley, 37 years old, Pompano Beach, Florida. 11 years on tour. So Handley open in the first. The defending champion, Jeff Bellinger, tied for 40th place this week. That was worth $850. He tied our statistician, Mr. Butch Soper, in that area.
Steady Butch always gets a check. Bob Handley is one of the supreme power players on the tour. One of the original, you might say, along with Mark Roth and players like that, who really started hooking the ball a lot. That's where he got that nickname, Hooks Handley. He can really turn it over. Unfortunately, if you don't keep the ball in the pocket area, it doesn't matter how well you roll the ball, it's still going to get splits. You've got to hit the pocket, Jay, whether you're going straight or whether you're hooking it a lot, it doesn't matter.
Well, here he is. He was open
now, watch
in the first.
Wrist. He's a cup wrist. Come very hard up the side of the ball, and look how his sliding foot is sideways. That's because he pulls so hard on the ball at the bottom of the swing to get that power, it actually pulls his body sideways.
6-7-10. Oh, he almost was able to convert it. Now, Handley has a very rugged start.
Now, here he's going cross lane, a lot of speed. Bob can throw the ball very hard. Watch the six pin go right behind the seven. Almost made it, Jay.
Five-8 leave for Ozio after striking in the first.
Now, the player coming on who finished higher in the standings of the five players today, for example, Bob Handley, Dave Ozio won the match before, so Bob Handley was higher in the standings. He gets to pick the starting lane that he wants to start on and finish on. So he decided, after watching Dave Ozio finish the last match, and struggle on the right-hand lane that he wanted David Ozio to have to finish on lane 64, and there's the reason why. David, if you remember, in the last two shots he had in the previous match, he had trouble on this lane. Here's a good look at that spare shot. The lane is changing. He isn't able to hit the pocket on this lane, and Bob Handley is hoping it will give him troubles the rest of the match, especially in the 10th frame, Jay. But he's hit this lane extremely well.
And the 10-pin is standing. It's a little like the psychology sometimes of winning the coin toss and taking the wind rather than
exactly.
the ball.
That's a good analogy, Jay. That's right.
21 of the 30 events this year, Mr. Ozio has picked up a check. Picks up the 10. They had three pro-ams in conjunction with this Milwaukee Classic here at the red carpet Sunday lanes earlier in the week. The youth pro-am, the senior pro-am, and the adult pro-am. They do love their bowling here in Milwaukee. Ten-pin.
Best shot of the match so far for Bob Handley. As you know, he's hit the nose twice in a row. The way he sets up at the line on the approach, Jay, it just demonstrates that power. He gets that elbow way inside. He locks it in there, rotates around the ball with all that wrist strength. He's a big, strong kid. And here's that hard, straight shot cross lane at the spare. Look out.
In the channel.
Well, he's going at a great pace here. 9 a frame, Jay.
Earl, it looked like he had a little trouble with his balance here.
Well, he's always this way. He's always sideways at the line. He pulls very hard on the ball. You can see that's typical of Bob right there. It's not typical that he would miss the spare. He's normally a great spare shooter, but it's typical that he would be arms flying and legs flying, and that's how he generally looks at the foul line.
A 3-6-10 for Handley. Mentioned this is the 24th consecutive year that the PBA has come to Milwaukee, and Milwaukee's the home of bowling's two largest membership organizations, the American Bowling Congress and the Women's International Bowling Congress. Regular television shows here in this market year-round, and lots of bowling action.
Cross lane again, a lot of speed.
And he raises his hand in jubilation. More action from the Milwaukee Classic, the red carpet celebrity lanes, right after this.
You have heartburn with headache, right?
Yeah.
Oh, boy, that's great. I have the perfect remedy. It's fast and nothing's more effective.
Alka-Seltzer.
New advanced formula Alka-Seltzer.
Nah, I can't take Alka-Seltzer.
This one's easy to take. It has 75% less sodium, a fresh lemony taste, and you can take it with just a little water. How was it?
Great, but it's not Alka-Seltzer.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
It is.
Yes,
it is. Don't you feel better?
Yes, but it's not Alka-Seltzer.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it is.
New advanced formula. Believe it or not, it's Alka-Seltzer.
No, it isn't.
Toyota's 1990 4x4. Don't leave the road without it.
When you've got your power stroke going, you've got confidence that nothing's going to beat you. Introducing Power Stick, the new antiperspirant that gives you 24-hour odor and wetness protection in just one wide stroke. It takes two strokes of the leading stick to match Power Stick's one-stroke protection, 24-hour protection. In just one stroke, new Power Sticks from Fabergé.
Darrell Dobbs, the head man of the American Bowling Congress, does an excellent job. Handley right now in a bit of a struggle. Noticed early holding his hand like it might be bothering him a little bit there earlier. See?
When you bowl the way he does, as far as how hard he hits on the ball or lifts it, you've always got a lot of pain in your hand, Jay.
Ozio in the lead. And a 10-pin. in the fourth frame.
Now, all the players that Ozio has bowled against so far on this pair, 63 and 64, and this has been one of the toughest, most difficult pairs throughout the tournament, and all the players he's bowled against are the type of players that really lift the ball hard and want to circle the ball. They tend to want to arc the ball out and hook it back. Ozio doesn't do that. He gets a heavy end-over-end roll on the ball, and what that's done for him on this pair, as it gets tougher and tougher, which it will as the oil moves, he's more able to keep the ball in play and stay out of trouble.
Ozio now with a record of 14 and 11 on television after his two wins here today. And a strike in the fifth.
Here's a good look at that classic style, that straight up follow through. Watch the ball go well down the lane before it grips right there and breaks to the pocket. 10 in the pit, perfect.
Handley is there. His first strike of the match.
And it's the first time he's got deep enough on the lane and kept the ball on line long enough to get it into the break area he wants on the lane to strike. There's a good reaction. He's happy with that one. Now, if he can repeat that success on lane 63, it's still anybody's match. Only 20 pins behind, even though he's had three consecutive opens.
He was high here last time when he left the 3-6-10. Oh, my.
That's a bad break, and he did make a great shot, and... You know, what else can you do, Jay? He made the good move, the good adjustment. Now watch the ball right there turn over, cut through the heart of the pins. It was a 4-9, and it's just because the ball hit so hard. And that's the penalty you pay when you throw as much power as Bob Handley does. You carry the light hits, but you lose some of the heavy ones.
Bob's first title came at the 81 ARC out in Alameda, California.
Ozio left the 10-pin on this lane last time. He has made the adjustment, and this was his difficult lane. He's made a good adjustment. Now it's whether he can carry the 10-pin.
A little high.
Let it get away from him. He knew it was bad when he let go, Jay.
Ozio leaving a 6-10.
This is truly what the players talking about in the locker room. They say, this is a pro condition. This is the kind of lane condition you've got to make great shots. You can never relax. Concentration constantly.
And he is open. Well, they both had a little trouble.
Oh, boy. That's very uncharacteristic of Dave Ozio to miss an easy spare, the 6-10, where the ball slides by the 6, gets only the 10. Very seldom he make that kind of mistake in match play.
But he's got to be thrilled to be up 20 pins the way it's gone.
Right now he's trying to figure out how I can get some strikes.
He did. A strike in the 7th. Hope you're enjoying the action of this $125,000 Milwaukee Classic. We'll be back right after this.
Winners know what it takes to win. In this game, it takes more control, more power, more precision, more curve. One ball has it all. One ball dominates winning on the Pro Tour. The Black UDOT from Columbia 300. The Black UDOT, the ball of champions. Columbia 300, sold only in lanes or pro shops.
It began as a game. It turned into a battle. And now, it's out of control. January 28th. This time, it's war.
The on-off endurance test. The shake test. The impact test.
You'll probably buy only one furnace in your life. So buy the one that's built to last a lifetime.
The Lennox Pulse Gas Furnace. Take it from Dave Lennox.
For home heating, for cooking, hot water, or drying, choose gas. America's best energy value.
Boomer. Kelly. Armed and dangerous. The Bengals battle the Bills. The rematch of last year's AFC Championship game. Sunday.
Our final stop on the fall tour next Saturday is Taylor Lanes in Taylor, Michigan, the $150,000 Budweiser Touring Players Championship at 2:30 Eastern Time. Earl, that's always a special event.
It's a special event for the players, Jay, because as the name tells you, it's a Touring Players Championship. That means you have to have been a touring player last year to be eligible for this particular tournament. It's a 56-game event. It takes a lot of stamina to go through the week. And it usually means that the top players, the guys that are out there that are bowling great, are going to be on our telecast, Jay. So we look forward to that one.
Handley down 20. Gets the strike on 64 and hangs in.
He's definitely in there. Only 20 pins separate these two great players. Now watch the ball reaction. And here's Bob Handley's reaction, obviously. He's playing deep inside, trying to get the ball. Now watch what happens with the 6-pin. Just nudges the 10-pin. Watch it come out of the channel. That's power. The average player, that was the 6-pin, would have stayed in the channel, left the weak 10, what they call the weak 10. Bob's ball hits hard enough to kick it out.
Strike over on 63, two in a row for Handley, and his deficit is only 10 pins now. And Ozio, who struck in the seventh, set to bowl here in the eighth.
And that careless mistake he made on this lane last time when he left the 6-10 and let the ball slide by the spare for the open could come back to haunt him, Jay.
Ozio was high with that one, and he's got a 6-7-10. Let's remind you that coming up next, Al McGuire, his predictions and all the interesting facts about the upcoming college basketball season, and then we'll go to the desert for the Skins game, except on the West Coast.
Oh, what a shot.
Oh,
what a try.
He had it wobbling at 7. Was thinking about going down.
That could have been the match right there, Jay. He picks that up. He keeps the lead. Here's a good look at it. The plastic ball to get it to slide well down the lane. Now, this is, at the most, a 64th of an inch from being picking up one of the toughest spares in the game. Back live.
And a strike in the ninth for Ozio. He's down 2 pins as Handley has battled back in this one.
How he sets that ball. Here we go.
Oh, what a good-looking roll.
What a great shot. You're right, Jay. You said it exactly. What a great roll. Here's a good look at Bob Handley at the foul line. See how off balance he is, but he gets rid of the ball before it affects the shot. And there's the ball going into the pin area, and no deflection, lots of power. It's all up to Bob Handley.
We mentioned right at the top of this telecast, it's his first championship round appearance of the year. He wants to make the very most of it he can.
This is the shot that could win the tournament, win this match for him. Four pin. All right. Here's where we're at. With a spare and a strike, Bob Handley would have a score of 174. David Ozio has a possible 183, but he needs two strikes to win this match if Bob Handley spares here.
These two veterans grinding as we come down to the wire in this one. Oh, and Handley. Now, again, that's the second time that I have noted, and I'm sure you've noted it more than I have, there
this
he's had a little problem with his balance.
Well, he does that a lot, though, yeah, Jay. But it's right. Amazing that, see, what he does on his spares, he throws the ball very hard and straight, And look at him. You can see the look on his face. He cannot believe that he could miss that spare. Do you realize how big a target you have for a one-pin spare? And this is one of the best players in the world, and he missed a one-pin spare, Jay.
Ozio needs a spare and a strike.
Or a strike here wins it.
Right.
It's a good shot. Played it safe. It was a good shot. He should be happy with that.
Well, he's not very happy.
He's unhappy with the ball reaction. He's happy with the shot, the way he played the shot. But he can't believe the ball didn't react better than that. See, he's confused on how the ball should react. He liked it when he released it. You can see the look on his face. I'll bet you he makes this spare.
Well, a strike would win it. Nine pins would tie it up, wouldn't it?
Nine pins, and we go into a roll-off, a ninth and tenth and frame roll-off, and it's very likely it will be nine pins.
Handley had a score of 162. Here is Ozio on lane 64. Everything on the line. Have a tie.
Now it gets exciting, folks. We go into a ninth and tenth frame roll-off. The maximum score a player can get is 60. So what will happen? Here's a good look at it. Now watch. This could have been a loser, too, Jay. He hit pretty high on the head pin here. He did get nine, but look at the last pin to go, the seven pin. All right, what will happen now is Bob Handley will start this roll-off. He will bowl the ninth frame. And David Ozio will get up on lane 64 and bowl the ninth and tenth. And then Handley will finish if necessary.
Handley comes up short. Well, Handley's got to feel like he got a new life after, of course, missing
well, both
that
of them,
spare.
Jay,
well, I guess both of them, yes. They both got to be shaking their heads and wondering what happened, but here I am. I'm still in it.
Well, look at, here's David Ozio. He's 248 the first match. Then he goes down to 196. Then he comes down with a 160 game. That's how difficult this lane condition is.
Yeah, you were very surprised at that score in the first match, I know.
And watch
great
this.
Credit. Now, there's the same mistake again.
And it's nothing to do with his approach, Jay. He's not off balance any more than he normally is. He's just making poor decisions and really bad shots. Bob Handley is too good a player to be doing this. He's throwing money away. It's like it means nothing. He's just too good to do this.
Yes. A good one for Ozio and a big step forward. Ozio talking to himself, urging him on.
Tough lane. Remember, this is his most difficult lane, and what a great shot this is when he really needs it the most. Watch the reaction. He needs any kind of a spare strike or a strike to win right now. Winner.
And Ozio in the roll-off comes away with it. Reminds me again that we've got the Skins game coming up this afternoon. Two tie, all tie. And that money going up and up and up with Jack Nicklaus, Lee Trevino, Curtis Strange, and Ray Floyd. That's except on the West Coast following Al McGuire's basketball special. Big afternoon of fun and excitement for you on NBC. Ozio is going to have a chance at the $18,000 first prize as he gets by Bob Handley. So it will be Ozio going up against the number one qualifier, Brian Voss. The championship match coming up.
Kelly McGillis.
You're the one.
Tom Cruise.
Man.
The all-American love story that touched the sky. Top Gun, a special event Sunday.
Are you considering a Ford or Mercury? Then look at Buick LeSabre. LeSabre gives you Buick's smooth Dynaride suspension, plus more horsepower and more headroom than Crown Victoria or Grand Marquis, at a lower sticker price.
What about Ford's Job 1 stuff?
That was then. This is now. J.D. Power reports Buick LeSabre is the most trouble-free car built in America.
It
took 2,000 years, but a revolutionary discovery is changing the way men think about coloring their gray hair. It's called Just for Men, from the leader in men's hair coloring. Simply apply Just for Men, and in 5 minutes, shampoo out. Your gray is blended away, leaving your natural-looking color. 5 minutes. Here, look at me. Just for Men leaves your hair looking healthy and fuller, and it won't fade or wash out. Just for Men, in the men's hair care section.
Next week, Evenings in Vegas.
The top 24 finishers here this week in this $125,000 event. Todd Thompson from Reno will be there for the shootout.
Hi, there's Eugene McCune, the son of former Player of the Year Don McCune. Sam Macaron, my doubles partner a few weeks ago, Jay.
He's tough.
He is tough. Has to be to carry me.
Has been bowling well.
And John Hannegard, he's one of the better senior players. John's 51, 52 years old, and he's showing the kids he can still do it.
Steve Wunderlich was very much in it and then faltered toward the end. Walter Ray Williams, Del Warren, Tom Baker doing well, man from Buffalo. Marshall Holman picked up 3,300.
Yeah, a couple of seconds already this fall.
Young man from Milwaukee had him yelling and screaming here last night. And how about Borish? They were here from Kenosha, really trying to root him into the top five last night.
And he won all eight games, Jay.
Yes, he
almost
did.
Got there.
And it'll be David Ozio going up against Brian Voss for the $18,000 first prize when we come back.
It comes with a surprise.
So where's the surprise?
In a minute.
First, this baby picks up stuff like nails and glass, and like a regular shop vac, it also picks up water.
So where's the surprise?
Just watch. You twist the top, lift it off, and you've got a surprisingly powerful blower.
And now ShopVac puts its power to work cleaning carpet stains with Spot Check. It turns any ShopVac into a powerful carpet cleaner. ShopVac. If it doesn't say ShopVac, keep shopping.
Xerex presents the Great American Torture Test. We challenge the bone-numbing cold of northern Alaska and pass with flying colors. Xerex. Because extreme conditions demand extreme protection.
Sears challenges so-called superstores to top this. A 52-inch projection TV for just $53 a month. Thanks to a manufacturer's reduction, it's $500 less. Thanks. At Sears and Sears Brand Central now.
A great Thanksgiving tradition. The Skins Game returns to NBC, where one putt could be worth $450,000. Whoa! Jack Nicklaus, Curtis Strange, Ray Floyd, and Lee Trevino play the Skins Game this weekend on NBC.
Here's the way it's gone. In match one, it was Ozio over Monacelli, 248 to 189. And then the man from Bider, Texas, got by Mark Baker, 196 to 166. And in match three, they were tied at 162. Ozio won the roll-off, 50 to 8 over Handley, who was open in the ninth frame. And now it is Brian Voss, who qualified number one. And Ozio, who's trying to come from the number four position to win it all. And uninterrupted coverage, as always, on NBC Sports in our championship match. Nice way to begin for David Ozio. His average today, 187. And that was after that brilliant 248 start.
Tough pair, Jay. And here's a man that is, in my opinion, the best shot maker on the tour today. Brian Voss, he can play any lane condition. He can vary his speeds. Just a great player.
That comes up short, and he looks down there and shakes his head. He sees wearing that Packers shirt today. now living in Boca Raton, Florida, 31 years of age. And
here's a good look at his style, Jay. Watch this arm swing, the perfect height. He gets down at the line, well over his knee, long extended fall through, and look at the balance, the straight foot at the foul line, perfect position at the foul line. And he's a good spare shooter. And I'm really showing you how well he's doing here. I'm telling you, he's a great shooter, and starts with an open.
Well, he made a good try at that. I was mentioning that Packers shirt as we look again at this shot.
Watch the pin action here. He almost got lucky. He didn't play it this way, folks. It just almost happened. That head of that 8-pin almost nudged out the 10.
Voss is the Payne Stewart of the PBA Tour. Stewart wears the NFL colors in the golf tournaments, and now he's got a deal. There he wears the shirt of the teams of Packers playing here this weekend against the Vikings. And a strike for Voss. The matinee idol of the PBA Tour, but soon to get married, they tell me.
That's right.
His fiancée is on hand today. There she is.
Oh, my.
7-pin.
Here's again, the player higher in the standings can pick the lane that he wants his opponent to finish on, and Brian Voss has decided he wants David Ozio to finish on 64, the lane that David's had most of his problems with. And here he made a great shot, left a solid 7. He couldn't really make much better shot than that. This I expect to be a great match, a close match, and a fairly well scoring match. Not great scores, but a good scoring match, Jay, because both these players are go straight enough with the shot that they can keep it in play and not get into a lot of trouble.
Ozio with a strike in the third, up by 11. Pretty lady there on the right.
Nice. That's my wife.
Her. Sure is your wife, Sue. Good to see her. Voss with career earnings of $717,000 plus. Two in a row for Voss.
And there's the adjustment that you're looking for. Not there, Jay, but right here.
That was Andrea Goff,
this is the
his fiancée.
Right. And you're looking for this kind of adjustment out of a great player. Brian Voss, as I mentioned, is a great shot maker. The first shot he threw on that lane was short, the washout. He came back with a lot of courage to attack the pocket that way and get the strike. Right back in the match.
Brian and Andrea have set the date for February 18th in Boca Raton. Feeling it now.
We'll see some demonstration from both these players. Great reactions, and watch this ball, how hard it hits. Boom. The ball almost ran over the 8-pin spot. It didn't deflect at all. Watch Brian run it out. Look at this.
All the way over to lane 65.
He almost left the building, Jay. And here's another man that'll run him out. If he gets it going, you'll see David Ozio show you how he feels. It's tough lane.
Well, we've talked about the ability of these veteran professionals. The lane conditions, very tough. Voss with 3 in a row. Ozio now with 2 in a row. And as you predicted, this should be something special. There's Ozio's wife again, Lisa.
Something that you really couldn't do this week, Jay, and that's trip that 4-pin. And David Ozio, when he let go of this ball, knew it was going to be a little short, a little high in the head pin. Watch the pin action. Come off the wall, the head pin to split the 4-7. Here's his reaction. What a break.
All right. First prize, $18,000 in this Milwaukee Classic. Is there, and that's 4 in a row for Brian Voss, who qualified first He had the high three-game series this week, 749.
And there's a good look at Brian getting the ball well out of the lane in the air. And the reason he's doing that is, remember when I mentioned earlier, the first part of the lane, the head area, is a little rough. The ball wants to grip it early. So Brian is eliminating that by actually throwing the ball over it in the air. He's getting the ball 5-6 feet out on the lane in the air, Jay. This is what bowling is all about. Two on the tour, anyway. Two great players going head-to-head.
Oh, the 10 is there, and he thought he really threw that one about as good as you could.
Yeah, but what a great run.
Yes, sir. After being open in the first, four strikes, and then here in the sixth frame, leaving the 10 pin. There's his championship round record, 24 and 22, and a 213 average over the years. We were talking with Bob Handley while we were in the break a little while ago, and I was interested in what he said to you. Now, here's a veteran. He said it was nerves, and I just was a little quick.
Yeah, and he said it was embarrassing to miss the spares like that. He got out of time. He rushed the foul line. And like you mentioned, Jay, he was off balance because he ran to the foul line, and that's why he missed an easy spare. It cost him a chance to be in this championship match.
And Ozio has four in a row. So these two fellas are really matching each other and making it happen in this championship match.
They are, and of course, you know, Dave Ozio feels fortunate just to be here, Jay.
Coming up next, Al McGuire's preseason basketball special. The coach, of course, had great teams here at Marquette, and then the Skins game. First nine holes of that dandy match from the desert.
All right, now we're getting down to crunch time. Seventh frame.
Boy, Ozio really on a run.
And I'll tell you what, Jake, it's almost impossible to explain how good he's bowling right now. This lane condition is tough. He's making it look easy. And he's bowling against, in my opinion, the best player in the world, Brian Voss, right now.
Responding with a strike in the seventh. Boss asking tournament director Harry Golden for a re-rack. Chuck Pisano, our television coordinator. Kevin Shippey of the PBA Tour on hand here as usual for the televised finals of a major event. Andrea Goff.
She's learning what it's like to be the fiance and soon to be the wife of one of the best players in the world, or if not the best player in the world, and go through this pressure.
Oh, yes. Finally, the seven went down.
And there's some aggression for you. He left the 10 pin on a great hit there on a string of four in a row, left the 10 pin in the six, comes back with a lighter hit. Watch the pin action, the power of Brian Voss's release. The pins makes him dance. Just enough to kick the seven out.
That was after he'd asked for the re-rack over there. And here's the reaction from this talented man who came out of the Northwest and now lives down in Florida. Ozio is the leader. And here he is on 64. Gotta hurry. Well, he's left the 2-4-5.
And what great shots he has made to string five consecutive strikes. And again, his tough lane, lane 64, is the one that stops him. This is not an easy spare. He switches balls. He's going to throw hard and straight down the left side of the lane, right at it. Careful. He wasn't overly confident of that, Jay. Here's a good look at, you know, watch the ball as it's rotating. It's not really gripping until right at that point and just gets enough to kick out the four pin. Ninth frame.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy is right, Jay. What a match we've got here.
This is certainly as fine a match as we've had throughout the fall tour this year, as Ozio and Voss are tied up in a dandy here. Voss, a possible 258. Ozio, a possible 257.
Right, and this shot, ninth frame, Brian Voss, to take the lead with a strike on two in a row, could take the lead.
High. 6-10. Looking at the scoreboard.
He's checking the score. He made a mistake there, which is uncharacteristic of Brian in this situation. He's usually very good in the clutch. He got the ball well out on the lane, but he just tugged it a little bit, Jay. Pulled it. Even the best players can make a mistake. The important thing is to cover the spare.
And he does. The lead is 11 for Ozio.
Brian can strike out for a possible 236. David Ozio going at a 237 pace.
We've had more strikes in this match than any throughout today.
Oh, what a great match it is, Jay. Mm-hmm. Goes down to the last frame.
Voss striking to start the 10th.
All right, this one, to put pressure on David Ozio, Brian Voss must strike here.
Oh, my, he leaves that 10 pin, and he really, really was pleased, I think, with that ball.
I'm sure he was very happy with the release. Everything went well, except as often happens even on the best shots, something stood up, and this time it was the 10 pin. But the match still isn't over, Jay. With the fill, 226 for Brian Voss, David Ozio would need a mark to win the match.
Voss, 226.
Remember, he's on his tough lane, Jay. Brian, 64. He struggled on this lane.
We'll say it again, he needs the mark to win. And this would be some victory, coming all the way from the fourth spot to gain the $18,000. His wife, Lisa, looking on.
That's a good shot, Jack.
Four pin, and look, he says, I can't believe it's down there.
But he's happy. Believe me, he is right now very happy. He can make the four pin, and if he makes it, he's a winner.
Oop, Lisa said.
It's hard to stay in that chair when when it's one ball for the title, Jay. All right. Pick up the spare and stay behind the foul line, and he's a winner.
Well, she's mighty happy. Brian Voss goes over to shake his hand.
And Brian said it all right there, Jay. He said to David Ozio, he said, good match.
It really was.
It was. It was a great match.
Splendid play by both of these gentlemen. And there is our champion, David Ozio, as he defeats Voss 236 to 226. A big hug from Lisa, and coming up, we'll be presenting a check for $18,000 to David Ozio, our winner.
She's all ours.
About some customers.
Ladies' night.
Great place, guys. Who did your decorating?
Now, at a pro shop near you, Brunswick is delivering a 100% urethane monster.
What?
We're delivering the power of a rhino.
The hardest charging ball in America. With five distinct formulations, Brunswick's Rhino reigns.
Janitor, to the pro shop, please.
Horn, horn, coming to you, a breathtaking corn chip that's really new. Corn crisp from Pringles, you got the fever for a fresh corn flavor. More corn, fresh corn, natural and whole. Cooked through a crisp and real corn oil. Time to Pringles corn crisp, so rich to fall. What you're gonna taste is fresh roasted corn.
New Corn Crisp from Pringles, the fresh corn fever reliever.
The game's high rollers.
America's top bowlers.
In a high-stakes showdown.
Lisa Wagner.
Mark Ross.
Marshall Holman.
And the winner of a nationwide competition.
A unique roll-off where the stakes go up as the pins go down.
The Bowling Shootout.
December 9th, only on NBC.
This has been the PBA Fall Tour, and today it was brought to you by Budweiser, Beechwood Aged for that clean, crisp taste. This Bud's for you. By Brunswick, proud sponsor of Team USA. By your Toyota dealers and their quality line of cars and trucks. Toyota, I love what you do for me. And by Sears, where you get your money's worth and a whole lot more.
There's the final match. The winner, David Ozio, Ralph Krieger, and Gary Hartel of the Bowling Proprietors Association of Wisconsin, presenting the trophy and the check to our champion, David Ozio. Next Saturday afternoon, join us for the action from Taylor, Michigan, the Budweiser Touring Players Championship.